Hello, everybody. My name is Zen, and happy Star Wars Day. Happy May the 4th. There's something that I want to point out to people who may not realize it, but in case you're interested in Star Wars at all, even just, you know, minutely, there are games that you should be playing, like, right now, that you can play right now, especially if you have Game Pass. So if you have Game Pass for either the Xbox or PC Game Pass, you have access to some actually amazing Star Wars games that you can play for today in case you're interested in playing any Star Wars games. The first two that I would suggest are Jedi Fallen Order, which Fallen Order is a freaking fantastic game. It's one of the best Star Wars games ever. And then you also have its sequel, Jedi Survivor. Both of those are on Game Pass right now. You can play them right now. I wouldn't recommend playing Jedi Survivor on like an anything under a Xbox Series X, honestly, or a nice PC. Though they have updated the game since its launch, and the performance is a lot better on the planet of Kobo and some other places within the game. But in general, I would say that Fallen Order is probably going to run a lot better just because it's an older title. And then Jedi Survivor, it had some performance issues, but it is also still freaking fantastic. Highly recommend it. And then you also have, you know, some lighthearted stuff like the Lego Star Wars Skywalker Saga. I love this game as well. You may think like, oh, it's a Lego game and it must be a kid's game. And that's not actually true. This game has got a lot going on in it. And I think that you should consider playing it. It's actually really, really, really good. If you do happen to have kids, though, it has a multiplayer mode and you can play with your kids. I really enjoy doing that as well. I play with one of my daughters. She does a great job with it. And we have a bunch of fun with that. I've barred the other kids from playing it. So it's just her and I at the moment. It's kind of our little thing. Then if you want something a lot more hardcore, Star Wars Squadrons is on Game Pass. It's a freaking phenomenal like dogfighting game. It harkens back to the old days of X-Wing and TIE Fighter. I really like this game, but some people may not. It's a bit harder to get into because you have to do a lot with your, it's not an arcade game, it's more of a simulator than it is an arcade, I would say. But Squadrons is phenomenal. And then finally you have Battlefront, and I don't mean like the old Battlefront, although the, you know, Battlefront recently had like a remaster come out, and that has a bunch of problems in of itself. Some of those have been fixed, but in case you're just wanting to play a, you know, a shooter, Battlefront 2 is on there, and Battlefront 2 actually has a really, really good campaign, in my opinion. I like it a lot. It's short and sweet. The game is gorgeous and plays well. So if you're interested in playing a bit of a shooter, maybe solo, right, as you go through the story, or just jumping into multiplayer, there's a lot of people still playing that game. So you can play Battlefront 2 on there. It's the Celebration Edition, so it's got a bunch of extra stuff in there. But those are your lineup of Game Pass games that you can play like right now for free. It's awesome. Now, of course, games for Star Wars stuff are heavily discounted across the board on like a bunch of different platforms, a bunch of different games. But these were just, you know, free options in case you already have Game Pass. Personally, for me, I don't foresee myself not having Game Pass. It's a really great deal. And I play a lot of games on there, so I think that this is a great time to jump in if you don't already have Game Pass. You can actually sign up if you haven't had Game Pass in a while or ever for like the $1 starter thing. So you just pay a buck and then now you have Game Pass for the whole month. And that's really, really nice because you're not just paying for, you know, the ability to play these Star Wars games on Star Wars Day, but you also have access to an insane library of games. You play like Starfield. I recommend if you want something a little more casual, Coral Island is on there. So is Stardew Valley. Those are kind of similar games, but I've been playing games like that a lot recently. So those are on my mind. Have a Nice Death is on there. Another fantastic game that I recently checked out as a first impressions, but that video will be going up this next week. And yeah, I think that it's impossible to state how great that value is until you jump on the Game Pass calendar. And or not calendar, but catalog, and you see just the list of games that you could potentially play at any given point. But for sure, play Jedi Fallen Order and Jedi Survivor. I love those games. I did a full series on the channel in case you want to get a preview of them. absolutely go sit down, have a great Star Wars day, and just play through both of those games. You're going to beat Fallen Order maybe in a day if you really focus on it, but Jedi Survivor is a much longer game. Don't expect to just blast through that. So, you know, a lot, maybe 5 or 6 very long sessions to get that one done. With all that being said, let me know in the comments what you guys are playing for Star Wars Day. Are you playing a Star Wars game? Do you not really care about Star Wars? You know, all of these are valid things. It's okay to like what you like or don't like what other people like. But until next time, we shall see you guys next time.